Jasmine here. So I'm going to be doing an update on the Thinx period panties. I have been able to wear them. Luckily for me, my menstrual cycle came in one day after I got my package. So I did do full commando with these. I did not use any diva cups. I didn't use any tampons. I didn't use any pads. I wore these panties as panties. So I will try to answer questions off the top of my head. I didn't get a lot of questions, so I'll just go over the ones that I had for myself. If you guys have any more, you can leave them down below in the comment section and I will reply. So right here I have a freshly cleaned period panty. Washing these were pretty easy. You do have to hand wash them in the sink to get, you know, the grossness out of them before you throw them into the washer. Do wash these separately. Do not wash them with anything else because you definitely don't want to get any cross-contamination, which is probably the only thing that people find disgusting is you have to wash these out in the sink. Ew. Well, honestly, guys, if you're using a diva cup, guess what you're doing? You're plucking it out of your uterus and you're throwing it into the sink and you're washing it by hand in the sink. It's not any different. The only difference is this is fabric, where the diva cup is silicone, I believe. So there's no difference. I used just regular warm, cold water to rinse these out. And I rinsed them enough where the water would come out clear. And then I put them in my washer by themselves. I waited until I had a couple of pairs. And I washed them on cold, like it said, on delicate cycle. And then it says to line dry. Well, here's my situation in New York. It gets really humid. And to line dry these outside on a very humid day is not going to happen. It took my comforter, which is finally dry, almost 2.5 to 3 weeks to dry outside on a line. So hanging these up outside to dry on a line is going to take more time to dry than it does, which is worth it, especially in the winter. I mean, think about it. If your house is old like mine, my house is 112 years old, we have really bad heating. So unless I hang these directly on top of the heater where it says do not use heat to dry, they're going to shrivel up and just fall apart. Now it says to line dry basically because of the fabric, okay? They're using the spandex. Okay, they're using nylon and elastane, you know, and polyurethane, stuff like that. That stuff shrinks when you use hot air to dry. So it will make your already form-fitting panties tighter. So what I ended up doing was I would throw them into my dryer on delicate, very, very low heat. It's basically just warm air. It's not like overly hot. And that seemed to work. And of course, I didn't get them dry right away. I would have to put them in twice. So to dry these on a very low cycle took about an hour, but you know, if you're using them and you need to use them, you're gonna have to kind of dry them faster, especially I only have 5 pairs, so I will be ordering more. I love these things. I totally hooked. I didn't have any leakage at all. My heaviest days, I switched them out after 6 hours. You know, I didn't do the full 8 hours. I did 6 hours, or when I felt like I needed to switch them out. And they do hold a fair amount of menstrual, so that's good. I did do them through a whole test. Okay, I went shopping in them. I climbed my stairs several times. I got up and sat down several times. I even rode my horse in them. And for sport, horse activity is the worst thing you can do to test anything. And by far, no leakage anywhere, not through the seams, not through the crotch, nothing. It's just, it held the way it was supposed to. And granted, I did put on a new pair before I got on my horse, but that's because that's just me. If I figured if I was going to test it, I wanted to make sure that while I'm riding for a full hour, that I wouldn't have any leakage. But by far, if you're into activities and stuff, like anything else, if you're going to do any kind of sport, you're going to switch out your tampon and pad or whatever before you do the sport. You're not just going to go, oh, I'm going to go swimming on a 3-hour-old tampon. It's not going to happen. People don't do that. I've never done that. So If you do, that's you. But I would recommend before you do any kind of sport, especially in the period panties, is definitely switch them out beforehand. That way you have a clean pair on. Now, as far as going to the bathroom, wiping and not switching and just pulling them right back up, I will say there was no wetness feeling. It wasn't like, ugh, sitting in a dirty diaper. You don't even feel it. Now, what I did notice, just like with a pad, you do have TMI coming, okay? Too much information. So if you don't want to listen, just okay. When you get the menstrual clumps on your pad, just like anything else, you do get those in the panties. So now what I did do with that is I just used a little bit of toilet paper and I patted that away. That's all it took. It was fine, you know. I didn't find any smell. There is no smell to it. You don't smell anything. You don't get that weird smell that you would get with pads or with your menstrual cup. Now, I do say menstrual cup because if you're using menstrual cup, you do know that there is a smell when you pluck it from your uterus. If you say that you don't smell anything, there's something wrong with your nose because I've always had some kind of weird, awkward, not fishy smell, but definitely like the bloody smell, the iron smell when it came to cleaning out my menstrual cup. So that's me being honest. Okay, with the period panties, I didn't have any of that. I didn't have any kind of weird smells. The only smell that I had was the fabric, okay, that spandex smell. They don't smell at all. You know, they're clean. They clean really nicely. They retain their softness. So that's good. Now, as far as sizing goes, they are snug, okay? They do fit pretty snug. So if you are a medium or a large or a small or what have you, your butt sizes. I did have a friend ask me if she should go one up in far size. I can't say because I would worry that maybe the one size up would be too big because these aren't really that snug. I mean, they're snug enough where you know they're not gonna come off. They're not, they don't give you a wedgie, they don't cause you any pain, there's no rubbing involved. It's just they're snug, you know, they're I think they're made to be a little snugger so that there definitely isn't no leakage coming out of the seams between your leg and your crotch. Now they do break in nicely. You know, I know, did notice that after wearing them a couple of times, they did break in nice and they started fitting a little bit better. Now there have been people saying that, you know, if you have a big butt, you might want to go one up because it gives you kind of a plumber's crack. I didn't notice that. I have a pretty nice size ass. But I still didn't notice any kind of plumber crack thing going on. But that's me, okay? The hip hugger is definitely a hip hugger. It does lay low on the hip. Just like with any hip hugger, it's gonna be close to your butt crack. So, I mean, if you don't like that style, then you can go a level up. But like I said, I don't know how it's gonna keep from any kind of leakage just in case. I think they're meant to be a little snug to keep leakage from happening. I'm drawing a blank. I don't think there were any other questions as far as that. Like I said, I'm hooked. I totally love them. I'm definitely going to be getting a couple more. I did hear that Thinx was thinking about coming out with like boy shorts style and oh, I can't remember what the other style was. Yeah, blank. But anyways, they're coming out with two different styles. So I'm excited to see those. I'm pretty sure they're going to be for heavier flow days also, just because they're going to be full form fitted. So I'm definitely going to be getting more. I do recommend, okay, if you have a cycle that's between 3 to 4 days and your heavier flows are on the second and third day, you're definitely going to need more than five. I actually ended up having to wash these several times and drying really quickly so that I had another pair to slip on. Also, the other thing is don't wear them wet. I did test that theory. I used the one that I was did the water test on. I did wear that one the following day in the afternoon just to kind of see that if common sense would say, yeah, it's not gonna last as long. But I did wear that one to see how much moisture would affect as far as how much it would hold. It did work really well. It did hold a lot, but I did notice that was the only time I had any leakage. And that was between the crotch area, right through here. So, I mean, it just where the seam of the panty was the only place it ended up kind of breaking through. Not a lot. I mean, it was still holding fairly good, but it was breaking through a little bit. So definitely make sure that your panties are 100% dry before you put them on, because that will definitely make sure that you're covered 99.9% of the time. That was the only time I had any kind of leakage. And it wasn't really leakage. It was, it's just a breakthrough. You could see that it was gonna happen. I did think about making myself a little fabric tote bag for these to stick inside my bag, my purse, when it's my cycle time, so that way if I have to go to the bathroom and switch, just in case. Like I said, I didn't have any problems. You can definitely wear these for 8 hours. If you're on a very heavy flow, however, I do recommend switching them every 6 hours, 5 to 6 hours. Now, a tampon, normally it says a tampon can hold up to 3 to 4 hours worth of flow for your regular heavy flows, but it also depends on where it's all going. Now, with these, they're definitely going all in the crotch area. These are made so that you can sleep in them, so they have a higher butt section so that when you're sleeping, you don't have any leakage out there. They do work really well overnight. I did wear mine overnight for the full however many hours I slept that night and got up and didn't have any leakage coming out. Now, with my menstrual cup, I did have that several times where if I clean my menstrual cup the night before, and when you're sleeping, everything kind of lays flat in your uterus, including your menstrual, so that when you get up, it all kind of flushes through, and then every now and then you have that the rim leakage where it's still leaking even with the cup in, and you're kind of waddling to the bathroom really quick to prevent it from getting everywhere and yelling at your family members to move out of the way, you're leaking, and they're like, ew, that's disgusting. Well, I didn't have that with these. It was really nice. It was one of those things where I was like, oh, I'm gonna wake up in the morning and these panties are gonna be flawed. I'm gonna have menstrual going down my leg. It's gonna be disgusting, and I'm never gonna hear the end of it from my little girl and my husband. Didn't have any of that. And like I said, with my cup, I did have that. I did wake up overnight and in the morning and get up, and it couldn't hold that much, and going down the stairs to the bathroom was always a rush, to make sure I didn't leak it all over my panties. And I've ruined so many panties because of that, because it would leak that way. And I have a heavy flow on my second and third day. Those are my worst days. It's like slaughtering a pig. So these held up so nicely. I didn't have any leakage, and it was like, ooh, yay, finally. So I definitely will say you can wear these without a pad, without a tampon, and without a diva cup. You can go totally anti-commando with these, so that's great. Again, you definitely need to know your flow. If you have a really, 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 really ultra strong flow, you might not be able to wear these for a full 8 hours or 6 hours. You might have to switch them out every 2 to 3 hours. That is totally up to how your body works. Like for me, I was able to wear them for, 4 to 5 hours, and on my light days, I could wear them for a full 8 hours and not have to worry. So as far as my review goes, I give these 2 thumbs up. Great work, thanks people. You get that did an amazing job with these. I highly recommend these to all my friends. And it's awesome. I can't wait to get more. I'm an avid fan now, totally hooked on these. And I am not endorsed by Thinx. I am not getting paid for Thinx. This is totally my own review. So if you haven't looked into these yet, definitely look into them. Read up about them. They are comfy. You don't even know. I mean, you can't even feel it. Website is shethinks.com. I will post it down in the comment section, well, in the detailed section. Check them out. Look into them. Like I said, I haven't had any bad experience with these yet. So there's my review and update for these. If you guys have any questions, definitely leave them down below in the comment section. I will get back to you guys as soon as possible. Other than that, this is Janine from Sassy Mustang 1980. You guys keep your heels down and be safe on trail, and I will talk to you guys later.